put that thing in sports. Shot it bad, pop it like a court. You a dork, never been a sport. Pull up, jumping out the court. Cotton candy, my cup tastes like the fair. Cotton, straight up there, where we didn't take the stairs.
Here and welcome back to my channel. So today I am back again with another video. Just as I promised, I was gonna come back with a wig review on the wig that I recently posted me actually cutting and styling. If you guys did not already see that video, I will leave a link to that video in the description box down below or in the cards above. Before we get into this video, be sure to click that subscribe button, turn on your notification bell to be notified whenever I upload a brand new video. And with that being said, let's just get right into it. I did do a video cutting and styling this wig to my liking, but I actually cut it and styled it on my mannequin head, which I would not recommend. I prefer to cut it on my head. I was trying it out on the mannequin, but the cut didn't come out the way that I wanted it to come out. So yeah, if you guys are gonna do this, I would recommend you cutting it on your head. This is the wig. This is a Fashion Source Collection wig by Simply Silky Lace, and this is a lace front wig. It retails for $49.99. I have it in the color one, of course, and it is called the SSL Yana wig. Curling iron safe from 350 to 400. It does feature a silk like material underneath the lace to mimic your scalp. This wig also comes in a lot of colors. It has a skin like appearance. The wig is a three part wig. Now, you already know, I'm gonna be 100% honest with you. Regardless, first thing first, it is not a three part wig, not to me. The lace is about 2 inches, and it says it's a lace front wig, and on the sides of the wig you get like this much lace, probably half of an inch of lace on the sides on your edges. So three part wig, I don't think so. I tried parting it in the side part and it just did not work out. Another thing about the wig that I find to be just a little bit false is the silk like feature that is underneath the lace. I don't think that it mimics your skin at all. Me personally, I think that you have to customize the wig to your liking, because once you slap it on your head, you're not gonna like how it looks at first. I'm just being real. It is very easy to maintain. However, if you are like me, you're gonna wanna cut it to your liking or make it look a certain kind of way, and I like my hair to look a certain kind of way. So if you're just gonna take it out the box like that and just slap it on your head, it's not gonna work out. It is not natural looking when you first get the wig. You're gonna have to customize it. I would recommend actually cutting it on your head instead of cutting it on the mannequin, because I believe that you can get a more precise cut. And I do also like to cut my hair to frame my face, and I feel like if you cut it on the mannequin, that's not what you're gonna get. I love hate this wig. I like it because it is easy maintenance. Once you customize it, you can just literally slap it on and brush it and you're good to go. When it comes to bobs in particular, I like to cut my bobs myself, and I also like to do it the traditional way with the weave, the tracks, and do it like that. But I do feel like with these blended bob wigs, you do have to customize it a little bit, and that is what I don't like about it. So if I had to choose between a sew-in and cutting it into a bob and a wig from the beauty supply store, I would probably go for the weave. I did do a bob I think maybe a year back when I did the Rihanna inspired look, and that was actually a bob that I cut myself. Also, I do want to say that I have not consistently worn this wig, so I cannot tell you how it's gonna do within a certain time frame. If you guys want me to come back and give you guys like an update on the wig, I can do that. If you don't want to cut it and you wear it just like that, then it's easier for you. So the wig does shed just a little bit, but it's not too crazy because it's not curly here. It is straight here and it's short, so you're not gonna get a lot of shedding. Said it is low maintenance, but it's just not my favorite because I prefer my bobs to be cut a certain type of way, and I just like to do sew-ins and cut my bobs. That's just how I like my bobs. But if you like this, I don't know, you guys let me know how you think it looks on me. It's cute for like a picture or something. You know what I'm saying? It's not something I'm going to be walking outside like, you know, being bad and bougie with it. You know, not all that. But it definitely is a little cute or whatever. You can rock it in like a quick little Instagram picture or something like that with a cute little, you know, jacket. To be honest with you, like, I almost didn't do this video. I just did not like how it was looking. So I'm literally here just trying to keep my head straight and not move too much because I don't want my hair to look crazy. If you guys are interested in this wig, I will leave a link in the description box down below. They do have a website, so I will leave that in the description box as well. But yeah, that's it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys found it a little bit helpful. If you guys want some, you know, help on how you could, like, you know, tease this wig a little bit and zhuzh it up a little bit, you guys can definitely check the description box down below or in the cards above if you're gonna go try to find this wig and rock this wig. And yeah, that's it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you to all my new subscribers, I appreciate you, and to all my old subbies, thank you guys for sticking with me. I will see you guys in the next one. I love you. Bye.